So 37, a solve for x. This one's more complicated. We've got a log on both sides of the x, of the equal sign. So we're going to want to bring those back together, combine them. This is really kind of starting to combine everything. Our properties of logarithms, we're going to use our log dance, and we're going to be good. So let's see how we would do this. My first step is you've got to get the logs on the same side. So I would move this negative by adding log base 5, x minus 3 to both sides. Log base 5, x minus 3 to both sides. And that's going to give us log base 5, minus 7. I could have done, yeah, so those stay the same. X minus 7 plus log base 5 of x minus 3. That all equals 1, right? Because on this side we get 0. Cancels out. Now when we're adding logarithms, we bring them together with multiplication. So this gives us log base 5 of x minus 7 times x minus 3, and that's all in one big logarithm, equals 1, log base 5. This would be the time, we're going to probably have to FOIL this out, but let's see what we get. We could do the log dance. This has a base of 5, that means it becomes an exponential that has a base of 5. The answer to the logarithm is the exponent, so that's the log dance part. The input, x minus 7 times x minus 3, there's our log dance. That's, and so we've gotten rid of logarithms. We now have an exponential, and 5 to the first power is just 5. This is now when we're going to FOIL this out, because you can't solve this. If 5 ended up being 0, then we would leave it factored and our answer would be plus 7 and plus 3, right? But this is 5. So we don't know that. We have to FOIL this out. So x times x gives us an x squared, right? And then we do x times minus 3 minus x3 minus 7 times x, and then finally minus 7 times minus 3 gives us a plus 21. Combine like terms, x squared, we get a negative 10x plus 21. And then to solve this, what we're going to do is because it's quadratic, we set it equal to 0. So we're going to subtract 5 from both sides. That's going to give us, let's go to change colors. That's going to give us that 0 equals x squared minus 10x. 21 minus 5 is, what's that going to give us? 16 plus 16. Now, how do we solve this? Well, we could just graph it and find the x-intercepts. What we ended up with, though, is something that will factor. 16 is either 2 times 8 or 4 times 4. Since it's addition, we add them and we're going to end up with 10, this time negative 10, so maybe they're both negatives, we'll see. But this addition, this plus says we're going to add them. 2 plus 8 is 10, 4 plus 4 is 8, so the pair we're going to want is 2 and 8. Okay, so we're going to factor this way. So this is x squared, x times x gives us x squared. The last two numbers are 2 and 8, because 2 times 8 gives us 16. They're positive, so they're either both positive or both negative. The middle term is negative, so that tells us both of these are negative. So negative 2 times negative 8 gives us positive 16. We're going to get negative 8x, negative 2x. When you add those together, you get negative 10x. So this is the proper factoring. And now we have two numbers that multiply to give us 0. So either x minus 2 is equal to 0 or x minus 8 equals 0 will give us two values that this happens at. We add 2 to both sides, giving us x equals positive 2. We add 8 to both sides for this one, giving us that the other answer is that 8, x is equal to positive 8. Not, well, it's not a 4, it's supposed to be an 8. Be careful, that's dyslexia. Sometimes I just write down random numbers, and so I always got to check myself. I don't know about you, some of you probably just don't have that problem, but it's something I struggle with myself. And actually, it's kind of why I became a math teacher, to try to help people who struggle in math, because I struggled with math quite a bit myself. But I had a dyslexic math teacher who helped me learn how to overcome the issues that I had, to use my thinking ability as a strength rather than going with the weaknesses. Okay, so 2 and 8, those are going to be the two solutions. Now, we got to come back here. Let's do a check, because remember, sometimes I don't think they're going to trick us too much on these, but maybe in calculus we do. You cannot have a negative value inside of a logarithm. So so I just saw something. So these are solutions we came up with, and I was almost just going to walk on. I think I would have got this wrong if I clicked on continue here, because I didn't come back to check this. So watch what happens if I come back to the original, which I've messed this up a little bit. Let me get rid of all this distracting. It's all correct, so you can come back to this. But let's take all this away, and now let's check our answer. If I put in 2 for x here, what do I get? I get log base 5 of 2 minus 7. Ooh, shoot, that's going to give me a negative value in here. And logarithms do not like negatives. They don't give us, we can't get a value. In fact, it gives us a negative value over here. We get log base 5 of 2 minus 3 is negative 1. So negative 2 is not a usable value. If there's more than one solution, separate when comes. If there is no solution, click no solution. So 2 is not a solution that works, but 8 would work. So if I plug in 8 here, 8 minus 7 is positive 1. 8 minus 3 is positive 5. So these ones will work. And let's just check it. So if I plug in 8, I get 1, so I get log base. Well, we don't have to check it. But anyway, 8 works, 2 doesn't. So what I'm going to do is come back here, clear it out. I'm going to take away this 2, because this 2 is not a valid answer. So they did. I didn't think they would get that tricky on us, but they did. Only 8 is the right solution. Just one solution here that works. Okay. Thanks.